Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is Thursday.
December 6th.
December
6th. 2012. I'm Anthony Gonzalez.
And I'm Gabby Kazin, and it's time for your daily dose of kTV Live Eyes on the Prize.
Had a little bit of a slow thing today. Today's just not an upbeat day. It's a sad day. Let's just move on through the day.
Yeah, so let's get into today's news. Today's kTV birthday is Andrew Cuono. Andrew Cuono was born on December 6, 1957, in New York. His father was 52nd governor of New York, and he helped in his father's campaign. He also served under Clinton, HUD's secretary. He is now currently the governor of New York. Make sure to wish Andrew Cuono a happy birthday.
Recently, there has been rumors going around that the NHL made an offer, and the season may finally come to a start soon.
Sadly, Jets coach Rex Ryan has announced that he is starting Mark Sanchez for Sunday's game against the Jaguars.
Right now in our classes, the eighth graders are learning about graffiti. Graffiti is the expression of words using symbols and keywords. Graffiti is a very illegal and should not be done by any means. Some people who use graffiti are gang members and such. Graffiti is used to mark territory or to be feathered by other people.
So, I am here with sports today.
Yeah, you are.
So, tonight in football, the Denver Broncos and the Oakland Raiders will face off for some Thursday night football. That's going to be a good game.
Yeah.
In the NBA, the New York Knickerbockers defeated the Charlotte Bobcats in a close game, 100-98.
Oh, that was a close game.
Also, the Boston Celtics beat the Minnesota Timberwolves, 104-94.
Good.
So, that's good for the Celtics.
Yeah.
And finally, Kobe Bryant scored his 30,000th point last night against the New Orleans Hornets.
Oh, that's really good for him.
So congrats to Kobe.
Yeah.
And that's it.
See you later.
All right.
Last night, Kobe Bryant just jumped his record up to 30,000 points in the victory against the Hornets.
The Middle East has just ended fighting with a peace treaty. Which two countries in the Middle East have just made a peace treaty? Is it A, Israel and Palestine? Maybe B, Japan and China, C, Afghanistan and Israel, or D, Cuba and Mexico. The conflict began in the 20th century and have left so many people dead and hurt. And the answer is A, Israel and Palestine. Since 1970s, there were a lot of failed attempts to get this treaty. Because the issue was so bad, the U.S. had to get involved with the struggle in the Middle East. Key issues were borders, security, water rights, and control of Jerusalem.
So we have an announcement with Matt over there, so let's get into more on that.
Yeah.
So right here I have a thing for moving and grooving. Moving and grooving is like a kind of like a dance kind of thing to improve core strength, coordination, and flexibility, et cetera, et cetera. The times for our age around there is it starts at 5:15 and it goes to 6:15 on Wednesdays. So yeah, go check that out. Let's get back into the studio.
That's really interesting.
Yeah.
I'm really excited about that.
Yeah, I want to do that.
Yeah.
So. Okay, let's get back into the news. Recently, an American named Sunset Thule has created a new technological tablet that only costs $20.
Today's kTV holiday is Miners Day. Today is a day to show respect to all miners. According to MSHA.gov, there were 69 miner deaths between 2006 and 2007. Coal mining created about 86,200 jobs in 2010. CreedHolden.com's motto about Miner's Day is honoring each and every miner, past, present, and future.
So, Megan, you're back here with the weather.
I'm back again for your double dose. So, today will be sunny with a high of 45.
Ooh, that's cold.
That's pretty, yeah, but it's bright out, so
yeah.
It's a little better. Tomorrow, it will be sunny with throughout the day with a high of 48. So, it's looking a little bit better.
Yeah.
Saturday, it will be rainy with a high of 57.
Good.
Yeah. And finally, on Sunday, it will be mostly raining with a high of 46.
So, you know that rain is going to kill us?
Yeah, but it's getting in the 40s now. It's getting a lot colder.
Yeah.
People need to wear their jackets. You know?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, okay. Today, we have an interview with one of the most iconic Christmas figures, Santa Claus, to see where he originally came from. What do you mean?
What is your real name?
My actual name is St. Nicholas, the father of Christmas, but simply known as Santa.
Where did you start this fabulous career of giving presents and sharing Christmas joy?
This was originally derived from the West, my original home, where I would deliver gifts to all the children on Christmas Eve, December 24th, to thank them for appreciating the Catholic religion.
Did you always dress in the red coat with the boots?
No. That was created in the 1900s by American and Canadian citizens, but I never really wore that.
What is the most popular thing you are known for?
A white beard created by the Germans to make me seem older and more jolly was a part of their natural history.
Is there anything you really love about what you do?
Oh, of course. I love to see the reaction of all the children when they open their presents. They deserve the reward for living as Jesus did throughout the year.
Santa is one of the most popular symbols of the Christmas season.
So
we have preview over there with Matt, so let's pass it over to him with more on that.
So yeah, guys, it looks like we're going to have an epic show tomorrow. We have a video about why you should keep your friends and why they're so important in your life, and we have an interview with one of last year's Star Power judges. So I can't wait for that. That sounds like a great show. Let's get back into the studio.
I'm excited about tomorrow's show. I can't wait.
Yeah, I can't either. So, for even more kTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Anthony Gonzalez and the rest of the kTV news team, I'm Gabrielle Schneeson. Have a splendid day.